Hey, Lovebox, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing, extended, beautiful family, thank you so much for being there. Being able to know that you can relate to so many different videos, let me know I'm not alone. It's truly a blessing. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you know when your girl's about to upload her next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your impact, the gift, and how it impacts your life and heading you towards positive direction. And if you feel like the video gives you good vibes or good, you know, information, please go ahead and share, even if it's with a loved one, family, or friend, or even a fellow empath that are going through some really trying times right now, need confirmation or validation towards their life path or their soul purpose. Or you can go ahead and give me a thumbs up and like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And once again, thank you so much for the love and support. It's so greatly appreciated, and I hope you're able to resonate with the content in my video. And thank you. So my meditation music that I'm listening to today is called, let me turn it down just a little bit, Inner Peace, Balance, Deep Meditation Music, Healing Music, Relax Mind and Body, Soothe and Relax. And I'm going to go ahead and place that link in the description box below. Yes, they're using the Buddha. You know, I tell y'all all the time I love Buddha because it's so relaxing. And after today, the day I had today, hey, I need to see Buddha. Me and Buddha need to talk. But today my video is about Twin Flame 101. Heyoka is when the ego is lost, the limit is lost. Yeah, because it's just like, you know, it's a beautiful feeling. I guess I've been doing this for like 3 years. You know, I've been actually going through spiritual awakenings longer than that. But it was like I got in touch with my spiritual self. I got in touch with my dark side. I got in touch with the unknown parts of myself 3 years ago. You know, everybody's still a work in progress. I'm still a work in progress. There's things that I'm still healing from. I congratulate myself. But, you know, it's just like sometimes we can dwell on things, or we can feed off of fear. You know, when you have so been in the dark for so long, and it's just like my life has always been like a cloud over my head, cloud over my head. And I was so used to being in that dark place, so used to being that person that even though I had so much stuff going on, I always try to give people a positive mindset, or, you know, something that boosted up their, you know, their vibes while I was still in that dark lining, you know, dealing with my own things, because I didn't understand why I was going through these things. Why did I always have these things happening to me? And it was like the universe was speaking to me a long time ago. I just wasn't getting it. But it's just like when you have gone through suffering, you have gone through trauma, suppression, depression, anxiety, those are the egos. You know, you're just constantly, you know, going over that painful scenario each and every time things have happened to you, whether or not it could have been 10, 15 years ago, or it could have been like 2 weeks ago. You know, when we allow the ego to just say what it wants and just like, you know what, have a couple of seats, I got this. Because it's just going to be at that point where you're sitting up there saying, I'm tired of being unhappy. I'm tired of, you know, being in this low frequency, not rising myself to where I need to be. You know, constantly going through these dark times. It's time for me to be happy. It's time for me to feel like I'm free. Free from the pain and the sorrow that I've been from. I came from, you know, free from trauma. All these things you're telling yourself, but it's just like you have to keep working and allow yourself to be able to detach yourself away from that ego. You know, the ego death, it's just like, especially with us going through these ascensions, it's like so many empaths. So many empaths are going through this. You know, there's some that I talked to on Facebook, and they're like, is anybody else going through this? I said, yes, June Ascension is coming. The June Ascension is coming, even though it's not until, like, what is it, next week? But shoot, this stuff has been kicking off for the last few weeks. We've been going through it. Like today, it was like, I was already dealing with so many emotions, like I was constantly releasing, because it's like, even though I've forgiven my family for going through this, this has just been a really trying time for me, you know. And it's just like, I'm proud of myself because I was able to release that and just close that chapter of my life. But there's just some sorrow that's still left, you know. So I was crying a lot today, and I said, you know what, I'm tired. I'm not about to do this no more. And it was like, you know, I hear my dad say, put on some music, just dance around, sing, do what you want. Because see, I was supposed to start my videos much earlier today, but it was just like, I was just crying and crying and crying and crying. And it was like, you know, I'm hearing my dad, one of my dad's songs that, you know, really triggered me. And it was just like, you know, not into a sad thing, but that was just reassurance. But it's like, when you lose a parent and stuff like that, there's certain things that's gonna, you know, the tears are just gonna flow. So it was just going through all those things, and I said, you know what, put on some music that you dance to, you know. So I was just putting on, I love the song Blue Eyes, you know, because it, you know, allows me to hear the guitar. It's like, anytime I can hear the guitar in certain songs, it's like, now I'm starting to get that musician's mind, like, ooh, there's that trumpet right there, ooh, you know, that's that tambourine right there, ooh, that's that bass guitar back there. And it was just like, I was allowing myself to feel the music, you know. I was listening to Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift, that song, ding, 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 ding. It's like, you know, fast-paced house music. So it was like, listening to all these things, it had me so happy, you know. It made me reminisce about happy things in my life. So it's just like, when you know you're going through issues and you know you're on that, you know, on that journey of healing yourself, when you get to that dark place, allow yourself to say, you know what, we're not going back there again. You know, this is the reason why we're working on ourselves, for us to be able to find ourselves out that rabbit hole. We need to, you know, just because we get halfway up the hole and things start getting frustrating, you come right back down again. No, that's not what's supposed to happen. We can't be doing that. You know, I was doing it myself. So it was just like, no, you put on some stuff, you know, put on some stuff that, you know, allows your soul to be able to sing. Allow your frequency to get high up there where it's gonna knock the roof off. You know, I was just another song I came from the soundtrack, The Dust Till Dawn. If anybody ever seen that vampire movie back in the day with the Greco brothers, with Quentin Tarantino and George Clooney, I love that part with what's her name, Selma Hayek, when she was doing the little dance. So I was, you know, dancing around and stuff like that, and I really love that song. It's Tito and somebody else, I can't remember the name, but it allowed myself to, you know, raise my vibrations, because I said, you know what, I'm not gonna do this. Number one, it's Friday, I ain't got paid and I ain't got ish to do, you know. I said, no, we ain't about to do this, you know, because it's just like, I've been feeling good. I have to look at all the accomplishments I'm making, more people that I'm being able to get in touch with. Yeah, it sucks that you're still healing, but that's the whole process of things, allowing yourself to let go of these situations. And it's just like, you know, even though you release so much, there's still a little bit of residue right there, even though you felt like it was gone, but obviously still in the psyche, there's stuff that's still, you know, lingering. So it's just like, when you allow yourself to not limit, you know, listen to that ego, the sky's the limit to you, you know. Because when we place ego, you know, on us, it's like we fear what we don't see coming. Even though you get so many signs, they're telling you, keep going, you can do whatever, this and this and this and that. But yet, if you keep on and, you know, interacting with that ego, it's gonna have you stressing, bringing on, you know, problems that's not even there, you know. Because if you start and, you know, interacting with ego, that brings negative vibrations towards you. And I have to tell myself that when you indulge in that crying, and, you know, even though it's good to cry, it's good to release, but when you're doing that, don't keep dwelling on something that's going to, you know, that's going to bring your vibrations down. You have to be able to set aside that ego and just like, look, I done killed you one time, but it's like Jason and Michael Myers, and keep coming back for another season. So it's just like, going through all these different things with this ascension going, this is what allows you to be able to set yourself free. Even though right now it really feels draining, it seems annoying, is bringing up a lot of things that you don't want to deal with, but that's the whole point. We're going through all the, you know, we had to deal with retrograde. We had to deal with the celestial, full moon, the other full moon that we just had the other day. Matter of fact, it happened on my birthday, on top of that, on the 19th. Dealing with all these different things, the retrograde and all this stuff that's coming up. Yeah, it can be very negative, but if we step outside the box and really look at it, it's benefiting us, because it's like giving us a jump start. Because what I keep hearing universe is like, when you're getting in touch with that, to say, you know what, I'm gonna find my best way to get up out of this situation. If I want all the blessings I want, that's what I need to stay focused on. Not focused on that past, because that past ain't gonna do nothing except keep me there while everybody else is getting their blessings. And the only person you can be mad at is self. The only person can hold yourself back is self. So it's just like, you have to allow yourself to heal, allow yourself to see the things that you have been working so hard for, the fruit of your labor. You know, there's things that you want better in your life, but those things cannot come in until you let the old stuff go. You know, they always, you know, when I look at my numbers, they'll tell you, let go of the old. You know, don't, you know, feed off of that, because that's fear. Because you keep, you know, keep going through that whirlwind of those negative things you went through in the past that hurt you, that brought you down, that kept you in a bad space. That's what they want you to let go of. We can't keep thinking about the things that has been placed in our lives to keep us there. That was the whole point. You had to go through this stuff. You had to be able to rise above, and then you can sit up here and say, you know, I went through this and I survived. Even though you are surviving, but it's just like, you have to see the better things of what that situation is bringing you. You know, that's just like, you're going to school, you done worked hard, you done did your homework, you're trying to get the A's so you can be able to graduate. We done already graduated going to the next step, but it's just all that other stuff. It's just like, you ain't learned nothing yet. That's what it looked like. Universe is saying, you ain't learned nothing yet. You just graduated. Now you right back to where you were doing again. So allow yourself to set yourself free. You know, you deserve to be happy. There's things that's coming into your life, but they won't be able to come into your life until you let that old crap go. Now I have to keep on telling myself that. What is that benefit going to hold? Yeah, you keep holding it, but that's all you're going to be holding. And you can't be able to have your blessings and still holding on to that past, because you can't be able to, you ain't going to have enough hands. Either you're going to have to let the blessings go or the past go. Which one is more better? Because this past stuff ain't doing nothing for you. But the whole blessings that you're trying to get is going to benefit you in so many different ways. You know, so you have to be able to let those things go. And I have to tell myself that today. Be happy. Be blessed. Look at all the people you're helping. Look at, you know, you can't sit up here and be helping them and you're not believing the things that you're telling yourself. Yeah. You can't be able to do that. So it's just like, yes, I'm a work in progress. I keep it real with y'all. Yeah, there's days that I fall short. Yeah, there's days that I get upset and cry and be mad and asking God why I got to go through this, or why this, why that, why that. This is the reason why. This is the main reason why, for me to be making videos, allowing you to know, if you're looking for this sign, that's the sign that you're looking for. You are that person that's going to get yourself out of everything that is placed upon you that people already said that you weren't going to be able to get out of. And just the fact is, it's not to prove them right or prove them wrong, but it's to yourself. Give yourself that validation for yourself. You ain't got to get those validations from everybody else. You're validating yourself, that you're saying, you know what, these things did happen to me. Yes, these things was placed in my life and it put me in a really dark place. But guess what? I'm not about to stay there. I'm about to graduate, drop kick this ego, and go past the limits that has challenged me. I want to challenge my limits, not have my limits challenge me, or even have your limits challenge you, because that makes you want to go further. So I hope you were able to resonate with the content of my video. I hope y'all have a blessed, safe weekend. Be responsible for everything you do. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved. And knowing there's always somebody out there praying for your better days. And my post notification shout out goes to Ritz Crackers, Taucha 88. I hope I said your name right. And Mimi B, much love to you as well. And I will see you on my next video. Like and subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. Share. Let me know if you resonate with these things, and know that you are truly going to get out your situation and you're going to be passing with flying colors. You just got to have faith in yourself. So I'll see you on my next video. Much love. Peace. Be wild.